Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you feeding methods of reflector antenna. In general, there are four categories of feeding methods with reflector antenna. First one is center feed parabolic reflector antenna. Second one is offset feed parabolic reflector antenna. Third one is Cassegrain center feed parabolic reflector antenna. And fourth one is Cassegrain offset feed parabolic reflector antenna. In this video, I'll explain all four feeding methods with great clarity. Let us begin this video with first feeding method, that is center feed parabolic reflector antenna. Center feed parabolic reflector antenna is the simplest antenna with reflector antenna category. If you observe, here we have parabolic reflector plate that we place it on parabolic curve. Here we have axis of parabola, and on axis of parabola, here we have focal point. And on focal point, we place feed antenna. See this feed antenna that will be usually on antenna. And that feed antenna will be transmitting spherical wavefronts. You can observe. See this feed antenna that will be transmitting spherical wavefronts. And this spherical wavefront that is getting reflected from this parabolic plate. After reflection, it will be having planar wavefront that is going in this direction, you can observe. So basic idea of this center feed parabolic reflector antenna is to convert spherical wavefront into planar wavefront by which signal can travel to long distance, right? Here, there are few essential key points that you need to understand, like it is having low cross polarization. See, low cross polarization, that is there because of design symmetricity. See, here we have center of this parabola, or you can say focal point of this parabola, at which we provide feed. And this is axis of parabola. If you talk about design, then you see on this direction and on this direction, design is symmetric with respect to axis of parabola, right? As this design is symmetric with respect to axis of parabola, there will be always low cross polarization. And always remember this, with any antenna, if design is symmetric with respect to feeding, then it will be always having low cross polarization, right? And it is quite simple to model. But there are few essential disadvantages that you need to understand. See, it is having issue of blockage due to feed. See, as and when this feed is transmitting EM waves in this direction, then the waves which are nearer to this axis of parabola, that is again coming back to feed. So there is a blockage because of this feed, right? The reason is the waves which are coming nearer from axis of parabola, that is again going back on this feed. That's why there is blockage issue with this structure. Second issue is there based on isolation. Let me explain that. See, this feed antenna that we connected with transceiver circuit. So here there will be transmitting circuit and receiving circuit. So transmitting circuit that is functioning at high power. Transmitting circuit that is functioning at high power, that one should know. The reason is we need to transmit signal to long distance. So always transmitter circuit that is functioning with high power and receiving circuit that will be functioning at low power, that one should know. Receiver circuit that will be functioning at low power always, right? Here, if you observe transmitted signal, so that is reflected from this parabolic reflector plate and again coming back to this feed. So high power signal that is coming back to feed again, and as high power signal that we receive over here by this feed antenna, receiver circuit is functioning at low power, so it may damage receiver circuit. So there is issue of isolation as this feed antenna that is coming in between path of travel. The reason is whatever signal that we transmit that is having high power, right? And because of blockage, again signal come back over here from short distance. So that high power signal may damage receiver circuit. So there is an issue of isolation. And there is one more issue that is there, which is regarding low noise applications. See, you cannot use this structure with low noise applications. Why? The reason is, here there is an issue of blockage, where we transmit high power signal over here and high power signal that we receive over here. So as if you have high power reception, but obviously it will cause damage in terms of temperature as well. So as if you have low noise applications, in that case, it is quite essential to isolate transmitter and receiver circuit, which is not possible here because of design symmetricity. So this design cannot resolve issues of low noise applications. So these three essential disadvantages are there. And to overcome those disadvantages, we can go for offset feed parabolic reflector. Now see, in offset feed parabolic reflector, what we do is, this is parabolic curve, and on this parabolic curve, with this much portion only, we have parabolic reflector plate. We don't have complete plate, right? With this portion only, we have parabolic reflector plate. This is axis of parabola, and here we have feed antenna. So, but obviously, we need to incline feed antenna towards reflector plate, right? So here we are providing inclination, but feed antenna that is there at focal point, right? Feed antenna is there at focal point only. Now here, if you observe, see, this feed antenna that is transmitting EM waves, so that is having spherical wavefront, right? It is having spherical wavefront, you can observe. And after reflection from parabolic reflector plate, here signal is converted into planar wavefront. And you can observe, see, whatever signal that is transmitted by this feed antenna, that is directly transmitted in space with planar wavefront, where feed is not coming in between. So here we are resolving issues of blockage. Previously, we were been having issue of blockage, because of which there was isolation issue as well as low noise applications that was not possible. But here, this feed is not coming in between path of travel of EM wave, because of which there is no issue of blockage. Here we have good isolation compared to center feed. Here we have better isolation compared to center feed. The reason is, here feed is not coming in between, so transmitter and receiver circuit will be having better isolation over here, right? But if you talk about geometry, then here geometry is asymmetric with respect to axis of parabola. You can observe, here we have feed, this is axis of parabola. If you see the geometry in this direction and in this direction, then in this direction we have plate, but in this direction we don't have plate like this. So this design is not symmetric. As this design is not symmetric, there will be issue of cross polarization. So we are resolving few issues with this offset feed. But after resolving few issues, we are adding one issue, that is of cross polarization. That was not there with this design, right? Now, let me talk about third category, that is Cassegrain center feed parabolic reflector antenna. With this design, we have two reflectors. One is primary reflector. You can observe primary reflector, that is parabolic reflector. And second is secondary reflector. You can observe the secondary reflector, that is hyperbolic reflector. See, here in center feed of Cassegrain category, feed is there at center over here on the axis of parabola over here. Here this feed will be always on antenna. Remember this. See, here this feed will be transmitting EM waves that is having spherical wavefront, right? And see, this wavefront that is reflected from this hyperbolic plate, and see, this hyperbolic plate that is reflecting this signal, and it will be again providing spherical wavefront only. And this spherical wavefront that will come back to this primary reflector, and it will be converting this spherical wavefront into planar wavefront in this direction. So you can observe, with Cassegrain center feed parabolic reflector, we have two reflector plates This is secondary reflector plate and this is primary reflector plate. This hyperbolic secondary reflector plate, that will be reflecting EM waves which is coming from this feed, and it will be converting spherical wavefront into spherical wavefronts only. The reason is hyperbolic reflector is having that characteristics which will be converting spherical into spherical only. Only parabolic shape that can convert spherical wavefront into planar wavefront, right? So here, see, after reflection, this spherical wavefront that is converted into planar wavefront by this parabolic reflector plate. This design that is symmetric with respect to center and axis of parabola with respect to feeding. One can say here we will be having lower cross polarization. Here we have good isolation of feed. You can observe here we have feed that is protected from outer environment, right? That's why it is having better isolation over here. See, it is good with low noise applications as well. The reason is here we are protecting this feed and we are isolating it with respect to external environment. That's why it is also having better characteristics with respect to no noise applications, right? And it is also having high directivity over here. The reason is here we are having 2x reflection, and usually we use 2x reflection with giant structure. Like there are a few parabolic reflector antennas that is having size of 100 of meter, and with that size you cannot use single feed like this. Along with feed you need to have secondary reflector, after that only you can use it with primary reflector, right? So for giant structure only we use this, right? And in giant structure you will be observing that, see, it will be having high directivity, right? And here there is one disadvantage, that is a blockage. Why there is a blockage? There is a blockage due to secondary reflector. So here we have secondary reflector that is coming in between travel of path which is there in this direction. So there is an issue of blockage, right? And to avoid this issue of blockage, in Cassegrain category, we have offset feed Cassegrain parabolic reflector, in which you can observe here we have feed that is there at center and on the axis of parabola, right? Here we have hyperbolic curve and this is hyperbolic plate. So here this feed that is inclined in this direction, and it is transmitting what? It is transmitting spherical wavefront only. After reflection from hyperbolic plate, again we have spherical wavefront only. And this parabolic reflector plate that is converting spherical wavefront into planar wavefront. That is how basic working is there. See, here there is no blockage of secondary hyperbolic reflector plate, and here there is excellent isolation of feed as well, and it is also good with low noise applications. But one more disadvantage that we add over here, that is based on cross polarization. Why? The reason is this geometry that is not symmetric with respect to axis of parabola, right? So as and when you have geometry which is asymmetric, at that time there will be issue of cross polarization. But this design is very effective in other sense, right? There is no blockage, there is excellent isolation of feed, as well as it is good with low noise applications as well. But cross polarization is there, right? That is how things are there. I hope you have enjoyed this session. Still, if anything that you would like to share, just note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.